and, of course, Susie Dent. Susie has a regular slot on Countdown called The Origins of Words, in which she explains the derivations of well-known words and phrases. And that's just one of the boring bits of Countdown we won't be bothering with tonight. Susie, is it true that Joe Brand is to blame for your email account going down recently?
Yeah, it wasn't really Joe's fault. Joe and I are trying to write a book together, and we're looking at the differences between the sexes in words. And Joe innocently, I think, asked me for the top insults for men. So I looked them up, sent them off to Joe, and about an hour later I got this red flashing alert saying that my account had been suspended. and I've got it here. In fact, if you want to hear what they were.
What were the terms?
Okay, so from the late 1500s, there was prick. that was a term of endearment, that's why I quite liked it. So it was a bit like darling, so you'd say, hello, my prick.
Oh, that's what I told my husband.
then we had knobhead, then we had plonker, which first meant something large of its kind. then schmuck, then twat. There's a lot of confusion in the 17th century about what a twat actually was. So for a while it was thought
to be... that when I was a teenager, yeah. Quite sure. Go on.
It was thought that it was part of a nun's habit, so there are lots of quotes was old nun's twat that you will find. The earliest record of twat is someone saying to his wife, give not male names to such things as thine, but I think thou hast two twats, a wife of mine.
I've got two twats, yes I have, yes I have. that old country's fair song. They'd stand outside pubs saying how many twats they had. Twat braggers, they were known as. I've got more twats than you. I've got more twats than you. Twats than you. Twats than you. I've got more twats than you.
Being on Countdown 5 days a week, Susie's written a number of books and has her own column in the Radio Times. Wow, who would have thought a lexicographer's life would be so boring? Sorry, busy. I meant busy. Susie, lots of surnames have got funny meanings. You got any favourites?
Yours is a good one.
What does it mean?
Power means great spear or big spear.
No, I don't want to overpromise.
Josh, Widdicombe, I think, means wide valley. That's quite nice.
Me and you, Jimmy?
Yeah, if we get together. A massive spear in his wide valley.
I've always wondered what mine meant.
Richardson is just the son of somebody probably very nice called Richard. But the first... one of the very first versions of Richard was Rico Hard. So that could be your nickname. Rico Hard.
It sort of already is. is a nickname a thing that only you call yourself?
Susie spends all her time in Dictionary Corner. It's the second most famous corner in Britain, after the Muller Fruit. now, Susie, some words have sort of unusual origins. Have you got any favourites?
Yes. I often get emails from colleagues on the OED who are kind of, you know, looking at the origins of different words. And this one is for sheep shagger. This was sent to me yesterday. Which was originally a nickname for the Black Watch, the Scottish regiment. And this is fantastic quote. I have to read this to you, at least I think it's fantastic. But I'm a lexicographer.
you find yourself saying that a lot.
Yeah.
But I am a lexicographer.
This goes all the way back, like almost a century. It said, the use is highly offensive and should not be used in the hearing of one member of the regiment, let alone a crowd. Even a subdued bat could be dangerous.
Yeah, you don't want to turn them on.
No. So there you go. It's not all boring being a lexicographer.
But mainly. Susie, are there any recent additions to the dictionary that you think we should know about?
Perf.
Perf.
Is it short for performance, as in Jimmy gives a good perf?
So is that perf with an F or perv with a V?
Definitely an F. I'm trying to think of other ones. Schwitz, as in we're all schwitzing in here. We're all a bit sweaty.
Schwitz is an old, that's an old Jewish word, isn't it?
That's a schwitz. Yeah.
You go for a schwitz.
Schwitzer is like half sweat and half white wine, isn't it?
Very refreshing.
Lovely.
With her regular appearances on Countdown, Susie Dent is easily Britain's most exciting lexicographer. Although, let's be honest, that's the equivalent of being Britain's deadliest marshmallow. Susie, are there any South African words we should look out for? We've got Trevor on the show. Any South African words or phrases?
Oh, I can't ever pronounce any of them, so, Trevor, you can put me right. Babalas?
Oh, babalas. That's
Babalas is great. It's a hangover.
Yeah, it's a hangover. Babalas.
Babalas.
Babalas. Yes.
I like babalas. That one. And then a buck fitty. Is that right?
A buck?
Like, it sounds
it's
like
so hard to... because when you say... You've got to remember... Because you say South African, but then there's 11, so I have to now go through all and then try and figure out which one it sounds closest to.
OK, buck fitty.
That didn't help me.
A giggly girl, basically.
No, that's not in my dictionary.
Now, Susie, how difficult is it to go from the regular Countdown to Cats Does Countdown?
It's quite difficult because I am only, as Rich will tell you, I am only ever funny by mistake. And not only that, but it takes me hours to realise what everyone is laughing at. So, quite recently, the last recording for Countdown, I decided I would liven things up by talking about the history of lingerie in the dictionary. So I was taking quite a few words from the dictionary and explaining them to Nick. And I went through suspenders and thongs, and I got to teddies. He looked really confused. And so I gave him the definition of a teddy, which was like, you know very well, Jimmy.
Sure.
The all-in-one. Yeah. And he was still looking really, really confused. And I said, Nick, I can tell you've never come across a teddy. It's quite funny thinking of Nick with a teddy. And anyway, I was driving home 2 hours later.
2 hours later?
And pulled over at a service station because I was laughing so hard. Then I texted Rachel.
I got the text 2 hours later. I finally realised where everyone was laughing.
Okay. Susie is a lexicographer. Well, she says she's a lexicographer. I suspect she just wants to be left alone at parties. Now, Susie, is it exciting when you discover a new word?
Yes. On The Real Show, I've moved to a laptop quite recently, and Jay, our lovely floor manager, delights in every time we go off for a break, I come back and he's looked up a new word for me, and so I discover about 5 new words a day, and my favourite one that he found was anitidaphobia, which is the fear that somehow, somewhere, you were being watched by a duck.
Of course, late in the afternoon on Christmas Day, Susie's family have to put up with a visit from Nana, or Carol Vorderman, as she prefers to call her. So, Susie, can I ask, every year, sort of at the end of the year, they do sort of a word of the year, and in 2014, it was photobomb. Do you think good choice or not, Susie? You're the expert.
OK, I can see I've been set up here, cos I found this under my desk when I came in. And a little bit earlier, I sneaked down to the studio to read the dictionary, as I do.
Genuinely, she's not a lot of fun.
And now I understand why this was left, cos, yes, photobombing. You might recognise the person.
So, yeah, I mean, that's...
That's the photo bomber.
Nice. Susie's regular slot on Countdown, The Origin of Words, is one of the most popular parts of the show, as it gives people a chance to make a cup of tea. OK, we've got Catherine on the show this evening, who's obviously Canadian. Are there any Canadian phrases we should be aware of?
I love Canadian place names, cos a lot of them are in their sort of native Algonquian languages. Mm. So is there really a place called Buffalo Head Smashed In Jump or something?
I've never been. We have Regina in Saskatchewan, right. And their football team are called the Regina Rough Riders.
The what now with the who how? Finally, I have a team. Susie regularly receives queries and questions from members of the Countdown audience. Questions like, why am I so cold? Is the war over? And why does my son never visit? OK, now, most little girls dream of being lexicographers. Was it the same for you growing up?
No, actually, I dreamt about working with the best comedians in the country, but it hasn't happened yet.
Susie Dent.
I just got dented.
Susie, how do you unwind after a hard day's counting down?
Well, there is one thing that Rachel and I do, and I blame Rachel entirely for this.
Oh, awesome.
Rachel introduced me to this website.
Oh, that one.
It's basically, you know, we love cats, and we quite like men, so it's poses of men and cats. And I bought you the calendar, actually, Rachel. Oh. Let's just show you here. This is the kind of thing we look at. What else can I show you? Ooh. There you go.
Wow. It's just what? So half. It's half a sexy man.
Yeah, it's amazing. It's got something for everyone, as long as you like men or cats.
Oh, that's the best one. Stay on that. That's like the weirdest ever hold up. That is hot stuff. I'm loving it. Oh.
Do they never make the men do what the cat decides to do? Like, one of a man just licking his underarm?
Or... shitting in a park.
I've got more drugs than you.